joined this evening by Congressman Bob Latta after you missed the snowstorm in Washington, D.C. Glad that you made it out on the last
one. Very glad I missed it.
Let's talk a little bit about health care. President Obama says he wants Republican input and trying to come up with another bill. He says that health care is not dead. Your thoughts on the talks? Do you feel like they're truly going to be bipartisan, or is this just a show?
Well, I hope it's not a show, because the American people want something done, and they want it done right. But what the president's been saying is, no, he's going to start with the two bills that have passed the House and the Senate versions.
Right.
Those are the two bills that the American people hate. And so, you know, what they want to do is say, hey, look, Republicans, you're going to come to a quote-unquote negotiations with the bills that we have. And I think that we need to go and say, Mr. President, we've had, you know, all these bills that we've talked about that we'd like to do, and also all these suggestions to have a good health care reform. Let's start with a blank piece of paper.
Okay.
Don't start with thousands of pages already and say, take it or leave it. And I think that's what he's saying.
Okay, if you had the blank piece of paper and you were writing it to the president, what would be the number one thing you would say to him?
Well, number one, I think there's, you know, several things right off the bat. I'm not sure I'd put a priority, but things that need to be talked about, tort reform.
Okay.
Defensive medicine comes out of that. You want to reduce costs. We got to do something about all these lawsuits. Then the doctors then wouldn't be worried about, you know, do I have to, if I already do A, B, C tests, now I'm going to have to do X, Y, and Z, because if I don't do those extra three tests, I might get sued.
Right, right.
So, you know, let's do something about on tort reform. Let's do something about buying insurance across state lines. Let's talk about pooling. And then also, let's talk about right off the bat, what about these individuals out there with pre-existing conditions and how we can help them.
So do you think items like that are going to be addressed, or do you think it's just going to be strictly the bills that are out there, take a little, and smoosh them together?
Well, that's my concern. I think that they're trying to do right now is say, look, let's take the two bills that we already have, the two bills that passed the Democrat-controlled House, the Democrat-controlled Senate, take these two bills, somehow work something out between the Democrats and the House and the Senate, come to the meeting already with their an agreement, saying, here's the bill. Oh, look, the Republicans aren't going to agree with us now. Well, I think that if you want to be fair in negotiations, that means you start over. That's what the American people are saying.
But if we start over, I mean, we could be talking into 2011,
I think I think what you want to do is this. Don't come up with a deal like they did in the House, a 1,028-page bill. It took me all weekend to read that thing. The first Senate bill was 1,990 pages. You know, I think they cut 10 pages out so people couldn't say it was a 2,000-page bill. But, you know, you take these bills and say, no, scrap them. Let's just take individual pieces out of them so the American people understand what we're doing. Don't come up with these massive bills like they did in the House that's going to control one-sixth of the American economy if this thing passes and if the bill is not done right. It's going to be a disaster.
Speaking of bills, there's talk about another jobs bill, stimulus 2, whatever you want to call it. Part of it is trying to get more money into smaller banks and trying to get them capitalized and go to different businesses that might need them. Do you think this jobs bill is in the right direction?
Well, you see, here's the problem. Again, what they don't do is like the underwear bomber on Christmas Day. They didn't connect the dots, they say, with the intelligence. They're not connecting the dots with a jobs bill. We have the second highest corporate tax rate in the world. They passed this cap and tax legislation out of the House, which would be the largest energy tax in American history. They're talking about this health care bill that's going to increase costs to small businesses. Then you throw in the EPA mandates that are killing a lot of businesses out there. You go to the regulations that's coming down from the Fed on banks that can't make loans to businesses that don't have any debt or never even missed a payment. But when you talk about on the FDIC side, I just talked to a individual who serves on a bank board of a small bank in our area. In 2008, their insurance, the FDIC, was $59,000. Last year, because of the premium increases by the Federal Deposit Insurance, went to $1.3 million.
Wow.
So when you take from $59,000 to $1.3 million, and they wonder why people aren't out there loaning and lending, that they need to put all the parts together in Washington.
Well, I guess in that instance, then if you go to $1.3 million, the bank doesn't have the capital to get out there.
That's correct.
So is there a bill out there, or do you think this jobs bill even gets close to helping something like that?
No, because once again, we're just throwing good money after bad. You have to go to the root of the problem. And again, it's that if you want small businesses to go out and create, it's just like with the president saying, give everybody a $5,000 tax credit in 2010 if they create a job. Well, the problem with that is, in our area, we've got businesses out there that have gone from 150 employees maybe down to 35 employees. They've had to cut those people back to 35 hours. What they're trying to do is just get their people back up to 40 hours and start hiring back.
Right, so just kind of get back to status quo.
So what they're doing, you know, all this talk is, in my opinion, is just talk. Mm-hmm. And pretty much even the Democrats in Congress are saying, that's not going to work.
Yeah.
And what we need to do, though, in my opinion, is you've got to look at the root problems of everything I said a little bit earlier and say, if we're going to get something done, that's how we're going to get jobs going again.
All right, Congressman, thank you very much for your time. We appreciate it. And that is tonight's Talk Back.